Yes, thank you very much. I'm very pleased to have this forum open today. We are pretty much impressed about the interest, and we are very thankful about all the contributors here. You are very important for our research. Yes, let's move on. First slide. Second slide. Facts about agricultural plastics. So, agricultural plastic has became an important asset in European farming. They're used for many different scopes. An important way of using them is through protected cultivation systems. This includes mulching films, tunnel, micro irrigation systems. So all practices that require the use of plastic directly on the field. There is also quite innovative use, like seed and microencapsulation, where you have plastic coating seeds or a capsule that have a slow release of agrochemicals. This kind of application results in an intentional release of plastic in soil that can be both conventional, polyolefin based, or biodegradable plastic. It is estimated, these are data from about 10 years ago, through a methodology, collected through a methodology that allow using all available data from different sources of information that cross-validate each other. Actually, developing an inventory of agricultural plastic is quite complex. So there is about 3 to 4 million tons of plastic in use, estimated, that produce about 1 million tons of waste per year. A large fraction of that, and that has been also confirmed by the report that the Commission sponsorized and was launched yesterday, a lot of this waste is mulching film or equivalent material using protected cultivation system. Agricultural plastic include both degradable and non-degradable plastic, while the bioplastic, biodegradable plastic are taking a small share of the market. Next slide, please. Okay, what do we believe? We are a group of scientists, and we believe that plastic culture has provided benefit for farmers in Europe and food production. Those benefits are acting at the short term, so it enables cultivating soil with crops that could not be cultivated different way in a given area. It boosts production, make production more reliable. It can also enable a reduction of use of pesticides, fertilizer, water, and energy. However, we believe that plastic culture can cause soil pollution. There are robust evidences. Also, visually, you can experience directly with your eyes that soil that are treated with agricultural plastic, probably mismanaging agricultural plastic, can result in soil pollution. As such, policies and practices that are designed today must take into consideration the long-term holistic sustainability assessment, including the assessment of ecological impacts and the impacts on the ability of soil to dispense ecological and agricultural services. We want to deliver to the next generation soils that are equivalent or even better suit for production than the one we are living. We want to deliver this to the next generation. Next slide, please. Soil is not a renewable resource. Plastic pollution in soil is poorly, if not reversible. We do not know what is the level. So the plastic will accumulate. Continuous inputs of plastic in soil will result in constantly increasing level of contamination, and we do not know what is the threshold. We call it resilience threshold. So the threshold at which the level of contamination of soil, beyond which soil will shift to a different state, possibly undesirable, with a lower productivity, for example. Next slide. So the use or management of plastic, agricultural plastic, results in fragmentation of plastic and down even to the micro and nano scale. So many of you are familiar with the problem of microplastic. These are debris that are smaller than 5 millimeters. And then we have the nanoplastic that are defined as fragment that are smaller than 100 nanometers. So this is even smaller than bacteria. We are close to the size of a virus. A large virus like corona, for example. So there are a lot of open questions about this type of pollution. What are the sources of micro nano plastic from soil deriving from the use of agricultural plastic? What are, of course, the impacts on ecosystem? What are their impacts on physical soil properties as well? For example, can accumulation of plastic alter hydraulic properties? Imagine a soil that has a different hydraulic property, a water flow in soil in a different way that will have indirect consequences on the functioning of the soil ecosystem and on its productivity. Is there an impact on plants' growth and quality? What about the chemical additives? We have big focus now on the plastic pollution, but plastic comes with a large number of different chemicals that are added to enhance certain properties. Those are also substances that are aliens to the natural environment. Also, we need to link this problem of soil pollution with a broader ecological context. We know that there are many European level strategies to protect water environment and marine environment. We have robust evidence that plastic pollution in soil can be efficiently transferred to water ecosystems. So, we should keep in mind also this element. We cannot protect one part of ecosystem forgetting the consequences on other part of the ecosystem. Next slide, please. So I go quickly through this because we had a great presentation from the previous speaker about the societal and policy demands. This study we are supporting with providing scientific knowledge, several strategic documents, starting from the soil health strategy, but we are touching upon the Green Deal, many elements of the Green Deal and the zero pollution ambition as well. Next slide. So Papillons has been one of the two projects funded under this call to look at the ecological impact of agricultural plastic. We receive a grant of 7 million euro. Our consortium includes 20 partners across Europe and one Chinese partner. We have a pan-European approach, as you can see, we are well distributed, and we will look at sources of pollution and impact of this pollution across different biomes in Europe and agricultural landscape. Next slide, please. Our work is divided in several research missions, and I go through the principal one. So the first research mission is about consolidating the European inventory of agricultural plastic uses, waste management, and potential micro nanoplastic sources. This will add to the nice work that has been conducted and supported by the DG Environment with a report released yesterday. They give some initial background. We will consolidate this by cross-checking information directly with the national stakeholders, but also in, for example, retailers, farmers, of course, retailers, importers, waste manager. By using this methodology that has been developed by one of our partners 10 years ago, we will be able to cross-validate this information. And the ambition is to create a pan-European atlas of agricultural plastic use. We also have the ambition to link these inventories to sort of a potential of inventories of potential releases of plastic pollution. And we will do that by looking at the technical and chemical characterization of agricultural plastic and look how this material tend to break down in different environments. So we really hope that in the next 4 years, we will come up with the substantial addition to the current knowledge that is still very fragmentary. Next slide, please. Another research mission is about conducting European spatial surveys to define, to shed some light on the current level of European agricultural soil contamination by micro and nanoplastic. We design a monitoring network across all Europe where we sample and analyze about 100 soils, soils that we know about also the historical use of agricultural plastic or other type of agricultural practices. We will look at the contamination profile. We will also try to correlate the contamination profile with changes in biodiversity by looking, for example, at the community of soil invertebrates and the microbial diversity to try to identify possible already ongoing impacts. Next slide. The fourth research mission is focusing instead of an experimental assessment that will be conducted in field. So I want to just remark that we are using a multi-pronged approach. So we go from spatial survey monitoring to different level of experimental assessment. This one is the most holistic one. It will be conducted in field, in experimental agricultural farms, where we will add microplastic to look at the mid and long-term effect by following the evolution of those soil and their property and biodiversity over 2 years. So we've selected these sites in southern, central, and northern Europe. We will conduct this experiment as a multifactorial experimental design where we can manipulate some elements. We will use the natural context locally present in each site, but we will manipulate by adding different level of two typology of plastic, one commonly used mulching film based on polyethylene after we grind it to create a micro and nanoplastic, and also a biodegradable PBAT mulching film, also aged and grounded, to simulate what we expect to see, the type of contamination we expect to see in a natural context. We can also play with the different levels of contamination. For example, we will simulate, we will have control, of course, but we will simulate present day contamination. And we'll also look at what are the expected effects over a long-term increased contamination. So with the much higher level than present day. We know from other parts of the world that plastic pollution in soil from the use of agricultural plastic can reach tremendous level. There are reports from China where there are fluffing layer of soil that can contain over 10% of plastic. So if we keep using or mismanaging agricultural plastic, those kind of extreme pollution cases are possible. We want to know what happened in the case, and we want to avoid to reach this level in Europe. Response variable include movement and transport of agricultural plastic, their fragmentation, effects on soil invertebrate, effects on microbial community, soil property, the ability of soil of exchanging gases with the atmosphere, and of course, effect on crop and plant growth. Next slide, please. Following our multi-pronged approach, the next level is to conduct similar type of experiment in a more controlled environment. So we will assess this facility in Amsterdam that enable setting up a mesocosm with soil, including soil fauna and crop, and add the microplastic in a controlled way, design the similar way as we did in the field, but in a control system, factorial experiments, where we could, after removing the geographical component, we could actually artificially manipulate certain parameters. For example, we believe that the amount of water has an important impact on the fate and transport of plastic. So for example, here we will manipulate this. We can also conduct studies by adding or removing the soil fauna to see what happened to the soil and to the transport of plastic. So this mesocosm experiment will enable a more mechanistic, less environmental realistic, but more mechanistic understanding of the ecological implication of plastic pollution in soil. Next slide. Similarly, what we did with the mesocause, we will also conduct a very innovative kind of study, again in laboratory. We are able to produce radio-labeled micro and nanoplastic that can be added in a protected environment, can be added in a, on a soil core. This radio tracking technique facilitates enormously the possibility of measuring, of observing how plastic move and how efficiently they can be incorporated in soil fauna or even in the crop, in the plants. So this will be the first time such an experiment will be conducted and will provide very useful information on how the plastic can interact with biota in soil. We also, I forgot to say in the previous slide, we also have a focus on chemical additives. So we will look at the movement of chemical additives present in plastic, in agricultural plastic, in a similar way as we look at the movement of the plastic itself, because we believe that the two aspects should be considered together, although there is a frame, policy frames for the chemical additive under REACH. But we believe that the standard, for example, in the case of degradable plastic, the criteria, quality criteria, including the standard, are not sufficiently clear with regard to the chemical, or sufficiently restrictive with regard to the chemical additive aspect. Next slide, please. Yes, and we have also focusing on more detailed laboratory scale experiment with single species soil invertebrate, where we tested different typology of agricultural, of micro nanoplastic derived from agricultural plastic. This again include always biodegradable and non-degradable plastic. And we look at endpoints such as survival, reproduction, energy allocation, growth, behavior. This will give an even a more direct species-specific assessment of the ecological impact. And we will cross this information with a more holistic assessment from the mesocause and the field study to generate a more general and aggregated vision of the ecosystem impact. We will do this with soil fauna, but also with plants, looking at the germination, plant cell responses, plant performance, biomarker, etc. Next slide, please. We are also interested, as I mentioned earlier, in the fate of further fate, how micro and nanoplastic pollution in agricultural soil can be transported to other parts of the ecosystem. In our project, we put particular emphasis on the water-driven transport. We believe this is to be an important pathway to link terrestrial and marine pollution and aquatic pollution. To do that, we will use this artificial stream where we can simulate different flow regimes with the water transport, and we will measure how plastic are transported. This includes also work with degradable plastic. We know that there is a concern about the degradability of degradable plastic in different, for example, degradable mulching film in different environments. So we will study that across our different region through the field plot experiment in the south, center, and northern Europe. But we'll also look how those residuals, biodegradable plastic that are transported to the water ecosystem will degrade once they are in the water ecosystem. This is not included in current standards for biodegradable mulching. And we believe, actually, this is confirmed from what we heard from the presentation from Silvia Forne before. It's one area where we need more knowledge to feed into the regulation and policy and the further development of quality standards. Next slide, please.
Sorry, Luca, could you wrap it up just a tiny bit?
Yes, this is the end. The project is run under the multi-actor approach. That's why you are here today. And we need to have this stakeholder forum on both to listen to our findings, but also to provide feedbacks to us. To do that, we have created a range of working group. Can you give the next slide, please? This working group include work with, we call them farm synergy, industry synergies, policy synergies. Each of these working group enable us to fill up, to complete one puzzle of this big project. So farmers will help us to consolidate inventories of agricultural plastic, will give us access to their soil to be analyzed for their pollution. We hope to develop a very tight interaction with the industry, again, to get information on the use and the production of agricultural plastic, but also on their technical and physical characteristics, their to share their information about the post-use management. And finally, of course, policy synergy. We are in deep dialogue with the key DGs, and we are hoping to develop also some interaction with ECA and EFSA concerning their stake, their interest into this project. We will hear from them later. Next slide. I just want to conclude. I'm very thankful. I hope I gave you the idea that this is a multi-pronged assessment. We want to develop a holistic vision over the problem. And I think that this is the demand that has been expressed in the previous talk. We want to fill the gap, the knowledge gap currently existing on the impacts of microplastic in soil and having a look at the long-term sustainability. So feel free to engage with us. We will certainly keep the dialogue with you directly and as part of this forum.